Last video we assembled the main, secondary and crankshaft, plus nailed the mounting of the two engine halves. And now we're going to place clutch and its cover.
To finish the engine from the other side, which is the left hand side, we want to build in the clutch and cover it with the clutch cover. The clutch in this build, I'm gonna use a Vespa Corsa clutch. It's from MMW, it is a used one, it is already 7 years old. I'm going to mix more hard and more soft springs. In this case I take genuine Piaggio springs 5 times and also SIP strength L springs. Every second spring is the other type. Then I put the basket on the base plate. We have this tool. It's the clutch compressor. It's a disc moving up here, and we can do it like this. We have the base plate, we have this little brass ring for the actual forces, and then the pinion gear comes on top. Then the screw and the nut. Now we can compress it. And then we can apply the discs. The first disc is the thick disc. It's of 2 millimeters thickness, as far as I know. I put inside here. Then I apply some oil. And then comes the first disc. It has the material on both sides. And then comes the next one, is not so thick. It's only 1.6 millimeters, as far as I know. And the last disc is the one disc with only the material only on one side. Now the ring. Voila! That's the clutch. Now the clutch is ready, and let's put it into the engine case. In this case, it's a big clutch of the PX200 models, actually the Corsa type. And this is a small engine case of the 125cc class. There is a rip on top of this bore, which has to be removed, otherwise this clutch will have a collision. It's easy to be removed by using a wrench, or you can mill it away or grind it away, no problem. Then put in the Woodruff key on the crankshaft. Next step, this washer disc between the bearing and the clutch. It's important to have the right thickness of the washer. In a lot of cases, 3.5 millimeters is the right thickness for all the modern PX type engines. Also, in concern of this washer, it's important to have a small gap between the teeth of the clutch and the washer, because when the clutch needs to be loose, it fills up this gap, so it moves very slightly, 0.1 millimeter or something, and it needs to have space for that. If the clutch gear is laying down on this washer from the very beginning, it will not become loose, so you have a problem then. So check the gap, put the washer inside, and then my favorite is to have some mild thread lock on the clutch. I do not use the very strong one, the green one, because it's very hard to disassemble it again, but with the mild one, it's no problem. Right after the clutch, the spring disc is mounted, and then there comes the nut. It's a self-locking nut, but still I use the thread lock on it. For this operation, we have this wonderful holding tool we can use with the original cover screws of the clutch cover. It is important to put in the screws a long way, very deep into the housing, because otherwise it will just break your thread. And according to our list, the clutch nut has to be tightened to 40 to 45 Newton meters. So from my personal experience, it can be more, but this works as the factory says. Apply 50 Newton meters. Now the clutch is built in, everything looks fine. Next thing to be done is the tightening of the secondary shaft. I didn't do it before because, as I said, when mounting it, I didn't want to have any forces or tension on it, but now I can easily close it and then it's in there. Our list says the appropriate tightening torque, which is 35 Newton meters more or less. Make sure that the sheet metal, the securing washer, is in its place. Now we can apply the clutch cover. For the clutch cover, if you use the big CNC type clutches, then most of the time you need to have a clutch cover which is milled in the inside to give space for the clutch. In this case, I have the MMW clutch cover, which is already old, few years. I apply a new O-ring on the clutch cover, and there's also a new O-ring here in the clutch lever. For the connection of the clutch and the clutch cover, there is the pressure plate. You can use the genuine pressure plate, which has a kind of a brass piston here and a hardened plate on the clutch. I'm using one of the oldest SIP products. It's called the XT2000. It's actually really, it's truly, it's 20 years old and it's still working. With these small M6 screws, be very careful because the thread is easily worn. The factory suggestion is only of 6 Newton meters, which is almost nothing. So you might laugh to use this this tool on this location, because you might think it doesn't matter. But once you ruined the first threads, you might start to rethink it. Okay, now we can fold the securing washer to the secondary shaft nut. And after that, we can start the brake assembly. For this purpose, I'm using the hammer. So once you mounted the clutch and the cover and you want to check the function, it is possible to actuate the clutch lever with these big wrench. And it should be possible to move it at least 40 or 35 degrees. And in the first part of the way, it should be easy. And then later on, you should feel the springs of the clutch. If there is very high tension from the very beginning and you don't have a first part of the way which is easy, the whole assembly is too tight. And your clutch will always be compressed. This is not good.
Alrighty, in the coming up part, we'll mount the brake. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. Plus, activate the bell so you won't miss out on any future projects.